Good morning. I want to discuss today a problem that a great many of my students are having understanding something called strike and dip. Strike and dip are used when we're mapping an area that has layers of rocks that come up at the surface at an angle, as we see here in this cartoonogram, all right? A couple of terms we need to talk about. You remember from high school geometry what a plane is. A plane has width and length, but there's no depth. It's a concept. It doesn't really exist in our universe. So if it turned completely edge on, it would disappear. It has no depth, not even one atom thickness, so nothing like that really exists. So when we talk about two planes, here's a plane one and here's another plane, where they intersect creates a line. Remember from high school geometry, the intersection of two planes is a straight line. All right? This straight line is what we're going to call the strike. Now, look over here in this example. We have a horizontal plane, typified by the lake surface there. And then we have layers of rock coming up from the ground at an angle. Where these two connect, the layers of rock at an angle and the horizontal lake, is we call the strike. That is the strike. That's where it's striking, okay? And layers of rock will do this even if there's a lake not there. We use a little device that if you take a geology course in the field, you'll learn to use a Brunson compass. But it's not really important to our discussion today. This is how we draw a strike. You see this? This little line that is this line here. Parallel. It is the line parallel to where the two planes meet. It gives us a straight line, okay? That is a strike measured off of north. Now, dip, on the other hand, is always, always, always 90 degrees to the strike, okay? Dip is always drawn at right angles, 90 degrees to the strike. And it's on the side of the strike symbol that's going down dip, down into the earth, okay? So let's see here what we have. The angle between this layer and the horizontal in this particular case is 30 degrees. You see what I'm saying? So here is our strike and dip symbol. The dip is 90 degrees to the strike, and it's going down dip, down this way, okay? And sometimes you'll see the 30 degrees written, in some cases you don't. Let me use something else to help explain this, because sometimes I have a lot of trouble with students getting this. This is a block diagram, or rather block diagram, excuse me, a block. I use this to show faulting and what have you. And here are some layers, green and purple and kind of a orange, I think, yellow, white, that are coming up. And here's our horizontal surface. Here's the horizontal surface, all right? And where those two intersect, my angle, my rock angle coming up in here is the strike. And so you have, if I get this where you can see it, I've drawn the strike here, okay? So show that, see if I can put this at an angle where you can see it. All right, can you see how the strike symbol is parallel to where the surface, the horizontal surface up here, and the layers coming up at an angle meet? Intersection of two planes is a straight line. And there's my dip symbol, 90 degrees to the strike, and on the down dip side, going this way, okay? Now we use this when we're mapping and what have you. Here's an area where you're walking along the surface here. You can't really see what's going on underneath the surface, but you have these outcrops. An outcrop is a place where the bedrock is showing at the surface, all right? And we see that these are all striking this way, all right? And the dip is coming in from under the ground at a 45 degree angle, and this way is down dip, okay? If we could see it from the edge, it would look rather like this, all right? Now go over this again if you have to. We'll talk about this in class in my lectures when we get to structural geology. And for my students, let me know if you're having any more trouble with this. Go back over these and look at them again and listen to the explanation again. This particular photograph comes from Skinner, Porter, and Park's excellent textbook, but you'll have one in whatever textbook you're using. We'll see you in the next video.